From the Rothman Center in Hackensack, New Jersey, it was the Northeast Conference semifinals with Fairleigh Dickinson outlasting Robert Morris 66-62. Paul Dottino and Terry O'Connor with you for this one. It was exciting. Fairleigh Dickinson was up by two at the half. 4 minutes into the second half, they were down by 10 as Robert Morris came out of the gate scorching. But then a 19-9 run by Fairleigh had the game tied midway through the stanza. And then from then on, it was a seesaw battle until Fairleigh wound up prevailing.
Well, they certainly hung in there, and there was an opportunity for this game to go all the way for the Colonials. When they had that 10-point lead, momentum seemed to be on their side. The pace of the game was the way they wanted it. When you look at the score in the 60s, that's what Andy Toole wanted, but the Knights hung in there, persevered. You talked about that and what Greg preaches about CPA and commitment and persevering and finally achieving. Well, they were certainly committed to the game. There's no question about that. Both teams were. Did they persevere when you're down 10 at home? Yes, you had to persevere. And then did you achieve? Yes, you did. You have a chance to go dancing. You got another opponent, though, coming up on Tuesday night.
Darnell Edge finishes with 20 points. He is the game high scorer and our player of the game. 15 of those points came in the second half. He hit the final two free throws to ice it, and boy, did he come out strong after the break.
Well, he certainly did, and during the interview, you know, he talked about the coaches saying to him in the locker room, listen, forget about it. That half is over. Can't do anything about it, but you have another 20 minutes. Be confident. Look for your shots within the confines of our offense. You'll get them. They'll start dropping, and they were big.
Can't say enough about Fairleigh's balanced scoring because they have five players averaging double digits this season, and they did it again. They get 18 from Jaleel Jenkins, the sophomore guard. They get 11 from Brandon Powell, the freshman who sets a career high in this ball game, and then 10 from Mike Holloway, who also contributed 8 rebounds.
Well, Powell's outstanding, as I said two or three times during the broadcast. The upside for him is almost unlimited. I mean, he can run the floor, he can score, he showed he could rebound. He was a real help out there today for sure. And Holloway, again, steady. You know, in the first half we talked about, he didn't seem to be down low much. Second half, they got him down on the box area. He got a few more points inside, which they needed, but he was also just tremendous on the defensive board.
And consider this, Xavier Malone Key, a double-digit scorer for the Knights, medically unable to play. His status is day-to-day with an undisclosed injury, and they were still able to outlast a very feisty Colonials team. Fairleigh Dickinson now has won 13 of its last 15 as they go into the NEC championship game for the first time since 2016, Terry.
Well, momentum is important at the end of the year. They started off 1-4. I think, wow, this season's going to be in the league. This is going to be a long year. All of a sudden, here they are, one game away from dancing. So, you know, the commitment, persevere and achieve, they have bought into that philosophy of his. And you can see it today. They hung right in there when they were down 10, could have been down 12, 16, 20, game over. Instead, they fought back with the run that you talked about, 19-9.
Congratulations to the Robert Morris Colonials and senior Matty McConnell, whose career closes today. But a big high five goes to the Fairleigh Dickinson Knights and Greg Herenda. They move into the NEC Finals with a 66-62 win over Robert Morris.